First of all, what went through your mind when you heard about Pulwama attack?
I was devastated. For one full day, I had nothing on my mind apart from this. I myself have worked in Pakistan, and I have seen the mechanics of that state very closely, and I immediately realized that this is something which has been planned, and these people have been trained there in Pakistan, so there is this cross border angle to it. I felt very sad at the loss of 40 lives. This was a huge terrorist attack, and these 40 lives meant so much to the families, but also for our country. The outpouring of emotions throughout the country has really shown our respect and our devotion for the armed forces and their courage.
Sinha, as an Indian American or as a lover of India, I ask you, when there is so much local support for terrorists in Jammu Kashmir region, it becomes even more challenging and difficult for army.
Well, I would accept that there is a local security challenge in Jammu and Kashmir, and our armed forces are within the constraints, within the ambit of the Constitution of India, are trying to provide security to the civilian population in Jammu and Kashmir. Those people who are not in the mainstream and are radicals, they are being made to pay the price.
You said now this is a new India, and you were referring to the way India is going to retaliate. And keeping that in mind, what is the difference that you observe in the new India in terms of dealing with separatist elements based, rooted in Kashmir?
Well, if you see the policy of this government for the last 4 or 5 years, government has been very cognizant of the security challenges and has taken a number of steps to improve the security situation. The radicals and the separatists being supported by Pakistan and are being dealt with very strictly. So that approach is quite visible in the government's policy.
Now, coming back to the action, there are two sides. One, support for the families of the soldiers whom we have lost. Another, showing that India is not going to take such attacks without any firm reaction. So on both fronts, let us first talk about so far what you have seen India has done. And I would also mention that now there is 200% duty on the goods coming from Pakistan and things like that.
Well, that is one of the first decisions which the government has taken. India had granted the most favored nation to Pakistan in 1996, and the reciprocity was not there from the Pakistan side. So in a way, we had provided one side trade concession to Pakistan. So with the withdrawal of MFN status from Pakistan, now of course the Pakistan exports from Pakistan or imports into India from Pakistan would invite some duties. That is one of the first steps which the government has taken, the government is everything has been articulated very eloquently by the Prime Minister himself when he has said that the supporters of terrorism have not realized how big this mistake which they have committed, and they will be punished for it. So government, through whatever tools it is available with it, will definitely try to to give a suitable reaction.
And lastly, I thank you once again for being with us here today. And the way world community has stood with India at this juncture, and especially very, very clear statement from America, I think that is also unprecedented. And
That is very admirable. We all appreciate it. The international community has stood with India in this time of grief and difficulty. Of course, appreciate a lot the support which has come from the United States government, the State Department, as well as the White House. They have made strong statements supporting India. At the same time, I would also bring to the notice of your viewers the enormous support which we have got in the Congress. Number of congressmen and senators, that number has already crossed 50. I think today we already had 56 congressmen and senators who had made statements supporting India and condemning the this dastardly act of terrorism against India. So apart from the support within the US, a number of countries across the world have conveyed support to India, and we all appreciate that support.
And lastly, BharatKeVeer dot.
Yeah, you mentioned it correctly. This is BharatKeVeer.gov.in. That is the website. On this website, people can donate individually to the brave hearts who have lost their lives, or you can contribute to the corpus fund. The distribution of the corpus fund is decided by some eminent people in India. This is a government monitored website, so there is no risk. You will also, anyone who donates money for the welfare of the soldiers' families on this BharatKeVeer website or the app will also get a certificate for this for their donation. So it is a much needed website and app, and I encourage all your viewers to contribute generously to this BharatKeVeer initiative.